Hello, Hire Chemist. It's Mr. Morton here. I hope you're all doing really well. And if you're not, well, you soon will be because we're going to do some chemistry. We're continuing on today with looking at gases, volumes of gases, and looking at the relationship between the number of moles and the volume of gases. In this video, we'll be covering learning outcome number 9 again from Unit 3 of the Hire Chemistry course, which is Chemistry in Society. Again, we're going to be using this idea of molar volume today. In case you didn't see last video, molar volume is the volume that's taken up by one mole of a gas. And when we have a chemical reaction with the same temperature and pressures, gases within that reaction, if they've got the same number of moles, will occupy the same space or have the same volume. And unless told otherwise, we can assume that the molar volume for a reaction at room temperature and standard atmospheric pressure is 24 liters per mole. Now, this is a point that again was iterated in last video. If I have a chemical reaction, let's use a different reaction this time for this video. If, let's say I had carbon and I wanted to combust it, react it with some oxygen to produce carbon dioxide. From what we've talked about up here, I can directly compare not only the number of moles in a chemical reaction, but if I've got gases as well, I can use that number of moles to directly compare their volumes. So carbon at room temperature is going to be a solid. Oxygen, however, is a gas, and carbon dioxide is a gas. So our molar ratio is 1 to 1 to 1. And if we're assuming that this reaction is taking place at room temperature at standard pressure, then I can assume that one mole of a gas has a volume of 24 liters. So that means then that if I've got one mole of oxygen in this reaction, it has a volume of 24 liters, and therefore so does the carbon dioxide because it's also in this reaction, same temperatures, same pressures, it's a one-to-one ratio, it's a gas, so I can directly compare the number of moles and the volume. I can't do it with the carbon because it's a solid and I can't figure out its volume just based upon the molar ratio. Let's say though that it wasn't a one-to-one reaction. Let's say I was producing 2 moles of carbon dioxide in this reaction from 1 mole of oxygen, then the molar ratio is now it's a terrible two, is now a 1 to 2 ratio. And instead of it being 24 liters for carbon dioxide, I would simply double my 24. So instead of being 24, since it's a 1 to 2 molar ratio, this is going to be 48 liters of carbon dioxide. So if I know one volume of a gas and I know the molar ratio, I can figure out another volume of a gas in that reaction. And that's what we're going to be exploring today with some examples. So here's our first example. We've got a balanced equation and it's asking us what volume of gas in centimeters cubed would be obtained by a reaction between 100 centimeters cubed of ammonia gas and excess copper 2 oxide. All volumes are measured at atmospheric pressure and at 20 degrees. So there's our clue, as always, that we're kind of thinking to use our molar volume and our kind of gas rules as well for this reaction. Remember, I can only directly compare volumes for gases. I can't do it for solids. So I need to really determine who's going to be a gas or a liquid or a solid in this reaction. Copper 2 oxide is going to be a solid, and therefore I cannot apply these gas rules to it. So I'm not going to use the copper oxide. It's already told me that the ammonia is a gas, so perfect. I'm going to use that. Copper, the metal, is obviously not going to be a gas at 20 degrees. Nitrogen, though, that is a gas at room temperature. And water, well, that's going to be a liquid at room temperature. So I've got my two chemicals in this reaction that will be gases. It's a 2 to 1 molar ratio. So if I have 2 moles of ammonia, I'm producing 1 mole of nitrogen. So let's just write that in over here where we've got a little bit of space. And therefore, since it's told us that we're starting with 100 centimeters cubed of ammonia gas, I can directly use the molar ratio with the volumes for gases and say that the gas produced, which is nitrogen, will have a volume of half of what I started with, because it's a 2-to-1 ratio. 2 moles has a volume of 100 centimeters cubed for a gas in this reaction, so 1 mole will have a volume of 50 centimeters cubed. So our answer is A. Here we've got example number 2. Slightly different question this time, but it's using the exact same method, exact same relationship. It's telling us that we've got propane is burning to form carbon dioxide and water, and part 1 is asking us to calculate the volume of oxygen needed to burn 50 centimeters cubed of propane. So we're obviously going to need our balanced equation here, because I need to know the number of moles of propane and oxygen to then figure out the volume of oxygen. So propane is C3H8. It's reacting with oxygen, O2, to produce carbon dioxide and water. Now we need to balance this equation. I've got 3 carbons on the left-hand side and only 1 on the right-hand side. So I'm going to have to put a 3 in front of the CO2 to balance it. 8 hydrogens on the left, only 2 on the right. So I'll need to put a 4 in front of the H2O to balance that. And then finally, let's look at how many oxygens I've got. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 4 times 1 is a total of 10 oxygens on the right. So I'll need to put a 5 in front of the O2, and there we go, I've balanced my chemical equation. I can now get the molar ratio between the propane and the oxygen. It's a 1-to-5 molar ratio, and as we know, if I have a volume of a gas, I can use the mole ratio to directly compare the other volumes of other gases as well. So 1 mole has a volume of 50 centimeters cubed, therefore to go from 1 mole to 5 moles for oxygen, I just times it by 5. So I would have 250 centimeters cubed of oxygen would be required to react with my 50 centimeters cubed of propane. And then part 2, pretty much the exact same question as part 1, but it's even easier because we've already got the balance equation this time. Calculate the volume of carbon dioxide produced from this 50 centimeters cubed of propane. Well, I know that in this balanced equation, I have 1 mole of propane reacting to produce 3 moles of carbon dioxide. It's a 1-to-3 molar ratio. The volume for 1 mole of gas in this reaction is 50 centimeters cubed. Therefore, 3 moles of gas in this reaction would just be 50 times 3, or 150 centimeters cubed, and that's our volume for carbon dioxide produced in this reaction. And let's look at our last example together. Again, a slightly different question from the other two that we've looked at, but it's just using the exact same relationship: number of moles, volumes of gases. So I've got my balanced equation here. It's the same reaction that we just looked at. Got some propane reacting with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. And the question's asking me, calculate the volume and composition of the resulting gas mixture. And that's quite a common phraseology for this type of question. So if you see that, volume and composition of resulting gas mixture, again, it's one of these triggers, one of these clues from a question that should jog your memory as to how to answer this style of question. Again, we're only interested in gases, so I'm going to ignore the water, because it's in a liquid form. Sometimes they'll tell you that the reaction is taking place at 200 degrees C and the water would be a gas at that temperature, but it's put in a state symbol of a liquid, so we can assume it's taking place at room temperature. I'm not going to use the water. I can only do this method with gases, and I need my molar ratio. It's a 1-to-5-to-3 molar ratio. And now I do a little bit of working that's different from, I suppose, any other style of calculation that we've looked at so far, I'm going to make a table almost. And on the left hand side of the table, I have a column which says three things. It's going to say have. So what do I have at the start of my reaction? Need. What would I need to make the reaction work? And left. What would I have left at the end of the reaction? And I'm just going to fill out this table, and that will give me the answer. So what do I have? What values have they given me? They've told us that we have 10 centimeters cubed of propane gas. So I've got a volume of 10 centimeters cubed. And I've got another volume of oxygen for 75 centimeters cubed. I have got 0 centimeters cubed of my carbon dioxide because I've not actually done the reaction yet. This is just what I've got at the start of the reaction. So what do I have at the beginning of the reaction? What would I need to react this 10 centimeters cubed of propane gas completely? So how much oxygen would I need? Well, it's a 1-5 ratio. So in this chemical reaction, 1 mole of gas has a volume of 10 centimeters cubed. So 5 moles of oxygen would have a volume of 50 centimeters cubed. And again, I have got no volume for my carbon dioxide because I've not done the reaction yet. I'm just thinking, what would I need? So when I do finally do the reaction, what's the volumes that I've got left at the end? Well, all of my propane is going to burn and react away, so I'll have 0 propane left. I've already said that I only need 50 centimeters cubed of propane to react with the, 50 centimeters cubed of oxygen to react with the propane, because it's a 1-5 ratio. So at the end, I'll have 25 centimeters cubed of oxygen left over. They've given us 75, we only need 50, so I'll have an excess of 75. And I have actually done the reaction this time. It's a 1-3 ratio between the propane and the carbon dioxide. 1 mole has a volume of 10 centimeters cubed, so 3 moles will have a volume of 30 centimeters cubed. So the total gas volume at the end of this reaction will equal 55 centimeters cubed. And by laying it out in this table, I will get the mark for showing the composition of the resulting gas. So you get a mark for final total volume and a mark for showing where that total volume is coming from. 25 from the oxygen, 30 from the carbon dioxide. And here's a couple of examples for you guys to sink your teeth into now and get a little bit of practice on these type of calculations.
this is only ever gonna be this. Be this. There's this. There's this. But only ever gonna need this. Need this. There's this. There's this.
And here's the answers to those questions there, guys. Remember, for both of these answers, we can only use gases. So in the first question, I can't use the water because it's in a liquid form. And it's asking for the total volume. So I've got 100 left over of oxygen, 300 carbon dioxide, so a total of 400. So the answer is B. And then for the second question, they're telling us that this is taking place at 200 degrees. So I do use the water this time. It is a gas. And once I go through my steps, I figure out that the total volume of gas left over is 2,300 centimeters cubed. As always, guys, I hope that video was useful, and I'll see you again next time.